just give God praise for bringing Brother Ronald back to his faithful
flock. Amen.
Amen.
You fix your mouth to say you wish I didn't come back.
What are we gonna call it?
Gotta be inspired.
Let me know if you need some inspiration.
What's happening, YouTube? This is gonna be my trailer review for The Chi, Season 3, Episode 9. And coming off Episode 8, old Tricky Dick Emmett became the hero for that episode. But it seems as though they're making him a very, very polarizing character, because one week you love him, one week you feel sorry for him, then the next week you like, you want to choke the hell out that little rug rat. So we're going to see where they're going to go in this episode with Emmett. If you're finding me for the first time, please subscribe to the channel. Be sure to turn on notifications so when I drop videos, you get them. We cover all kinds of TV shows and we do stocks. So if you're not investing, download my Robinhood link. You get a free stock, I get a free one. Follow me and Larry and a special guest tonight. And every Wednesday and Fridays, we go live discussing TV shows and stocks. Let's finish the rest of this trailer and then we'll break it down clip by clip.
You ain't gotta do this. This ain't no game.
I don't have to leave to get a fresh start, right?
Time for me to go build a life somewhere else.
First clip, we see Ronnie, that I quit calling Rusty a long time ago because of the resurrection of who he is. Looks like he's in Papa's Daddy's church. And you can see Papa's Daddy right there panning through the crowd as he's standing up there about to present Ronnie as the hero. Then in the crowd, you see Tracy. Me and Larry been trying to figure out what the hell happened to her the whole season. They just decide we ain't gonna use her but for those first two episodes. But you see she's coming back. Maybe Ronnie has become the hero. And you guys always know the hero gets a girl. So maybe that's what they're gonna do with Ronnie in this particular episode. Then you see Kev and Keisha. And it's good to see them just kind of kicking it with each other. But, you know, she's criticizing him for saying that, you know, she warranted what happened to her. And I'm sure Kev will have a greater level of understanding and try to explain what he really meant in the heat of the moment. And Kev's going through a lot right now himself, not more than what she went through, which he needs to have a level of discernment for her. But ladies and gentlemen, he's still a teen. They're both teens, and maybe he can pull it together, because I do genuinely believe they love each other. And next, here we go with our man Emmett. Lord have mercy, cutting a ribbon. Now, do they think we supposed to just believe that Sonny is just gonna go away without a fight? Did you guys see how mad Sonny was last episode? And when he sees this, I'm sure he's somewhere lurking in the crowd watching Emmett use them scissors, and he's probably thinking, I could take them scissors and stab him right in his eyeball or cut off that penis he loved to use to make babies. Clapping with Dominique. Then you see him in the store, Emmett just happy over his good work. And then this is the most telling clip of this whole trailer. He's looking at the backside of Dominique and Tiff. And boy, what a backside to behold on both ends. But ladies and gentlemen, any man who's ever been in this situation, or a woman for that matter, when you're sleeping with a business partner and you've got a significant other, and they have to interact with each other, how do you rest? How do you sleep? To dumb butt Emmett. And he's standing there with both of them, and Dominique makes a somewhat snide remark, and look at the look on Tiff's face. She's like, bitch, please. I know what that's supposed to mean. So that's going to be interesting. I think this is how they're going to lead us into the next season. And then we see Jake and Trigg sitting in the Jeep. And basically, it seems like Trigg is putting Jake up to get some deeper information on Duda. Next clip, we see Jake going through the closet in the house at Duda's crib. And look who's standing there to catch him in the midst of his digging. It is Miss Candy taking a good look at Jake, basically saying, what the hell are you doing? Now, I think this is TV deception, ladies and gentlemen. They did not bring Candy in this thing just to be Duda's side piece. She was brought here to create some controversy somewhere. And since her sex scenes created controversy, not the way they wanted us to have the controversy in a bad way, maybe she is gonna help Jake stab Duda in the back. And I'm still waiting to see if she's gonna go help Lena Waithe, and excuse me, Lena Waithe's character in the campaign to become mayor, because Candy has got to do more than this. I hype this chick up because y'all know I love Escape, I love Candy, and I've got a deep love for Lena Waithe too. And so I'm expecting something deeper to happen from this scene. And then they end up on Ronnie walking with the girl, and I'm glad that he's going to get the girl. And it looks like he's holding the urn that's got his grandmother in it. And you see Tracy and him standing somewhere by some water, basically saying, Ronnie, are you finally going to leave the city? And I think Ronnie's kind of hemmed up about that process. Maybe he doesn't want to leave now. Maybe he wants to plant roots here, join Papa's dad's church and become, you know, maybe a deacon in the church or whatever. And then you see him looking inside the urn. But ladies and gentlemen, what if there's no ashes in there? What if he looks in there and then there's a deeper revelation for him of maybe something else that either the missing ashes tells him to do, or that the ashes that are in there says, you know, maybe you can plant your roots here, be a loving man to Tracy, be a loving deacon in the church, help some other women, whatever. You guys leave me all your comments on what you think is going to happen in this episode with each one of these characters. And that's going to do it for this video. Don't forget to like the video, comment, subscribe. Get yourself that life game. Follow me and shoot me messages on Instagram anytime you got TV shows and stories you want me to cover. Also, download that Robinhood app. Get investing. Right now is a great time for you guys to buy some stocks at a low price so that they'll make you a lot of money long term, and even learn how to option trade. And follow me and Larry Monday, Wednesday, and Friday night at 9 p.m. as we go live, breaking things down for everyone. And until that next sexy as hell video.